Everyone, and thank you for joining us today for this episode of the Free UC with 2600 Hertz podcast. I'm your host, Clint Mose, and I'm back in action once again to bring you an exciting new episode. I'm excited to announce that after taking a few episodes off, Elisa is once again joining me. Hey, Elisa, welcome back.
Hey, Clint. It's great to be back.
All right. In this month's episode, we're going to be recapping the CloudComm Summit that we both attended a few weeks ago. The CloudComm Summit is a great conference that brings together thought leaders and service providers from around the country. And 2600 Hertz is proud to sponsor such an exceptional industry event. Although the conference unfortunately had to switch from in-person to virtual, it was chock full of important news, announcements, and insights. So with that, let's just dive right in and fill you all in on some of the big takeaways from the summit. So one of the big takeaways that we took from the conference was this idea that CPaaS plus CRMs are really the future of cloud communications.
That's right, Clint. That was actually a huge takeaway from the event because CRMs are actually the largest software market in the world, which honestly, I didn't really think about prior to hearing it, but after hearing it, it makes a lot of sense because there are a large number of CRM competitors out there that focus on industry specialization. So you have a lot of different CRMs to choose from more generic ones, such as ones like HubSpot, which is, you know, what we use, to very industry-focused CRMs. Like I know that there are some out there that are geared towards the real estate market, and you know, you have those for a lot of different markets nowadays. And the CRM market is expected to grow to $43.5 billion, according to Statista, in 2024. And that's huge. I mean, if you compare that to even the prediction for like the UCaaS market, it's nowhere close to $43.5 billion. So it makes sense that CRMs and CPaaS are the future because CPaaS is what will enable service providers to provide a customized offering for the specific industries and niches that they serve, you know, by incorporating these CRMs into their solutions and really making their platforms a one-stop shop for their customers. And, you know, once everything that their customers use on a day-to-day basis from a communication standpoint is integrated together, I mean, that's huge. Those customers are going to be sticking around because they're not going to necessarily be able to get a solution like that from a competitor.
Yeah, that's right. And this idea that how do you bring in the CRMs, like you mentioned, it's CPaaS. And Matthew Townend, who's the executive director for Cavell Group, one of the people organizing the event, had an opening keynote, and he was really focusing on CRMs and using CPaaS to incorporate and integrate CRMs into a service provider solution. And the Cloud Comms Alliance, the other organization that puts on the event, had a customer engagement focus. And in the survey of service providers, CPaaS and APIs was in the top three services that service providers are looking to add in the next 12 months. So as you mentioned earlier, Elisa, the CRM market is huge, and it seems like in the shadow of that, the CPaaS market is also poised to grow for service providers because that is the most direct way to integrate CRMs into a platform offering.
That's right, Clint. And I know that we jumped into talking about CPaaS and CRMs together, but CPaaS itself was a huge overarching theme of the event.
Yeah, totally agree. And that's something that we've talked about this on a few podcasts in the past. And I think it is, you know, really another big kind of trend going on in the cloud communications industry. And that was mentioned a number of different times throughout the conference. With all of these different solutions starting to look so similar, what winds up happening is the only way to really differentiate is to offer some sort of customization options. And CPaaS is really the way that service providers or resellers can create their own unique integrations to have a custom solution to meet their customers' needs.
Especially with all of the mergers and acquisitions that have taken place, I mean, even just in 2021, but definitely over the past couple of years as well. there's been a lot of consolidation in the market with solutions, and it's hard to sell on anything outside of, say, price when your solution is fairly similar in terms of the features and functionality that it offers to that of your competitors. And so CPaaS really is the one big thing that can help set your solution and your business apart from that of your competitors, which has been, you know, a theme for the past year for sure, probably a little bit longer than that. And I think that's definitely a trend that we'll continue to see in the future.
Yeah, I totally agree with that, Alisa. Speaking of larger industry trends, another major focus of a handful of different panels was the growing importance of CX, of customer experience. People were sort of hitting on this idea with the big work from home push that is now becoming the hybrid office. There's just this larger cultural transformation that's happening wherein businesses are needing to come up with new ways to handle how they engage with customers and also how they manage their own employees. So really thinking about communications stack not as an internal collaboration or an external outreach, but how do we get one platform that can do both of those things?
Absolutely. Customer experience has been growing in importance over the past couple of years as well. And, you know, we're really seeing that come to a head with exactly what you just mentioned, Clint. You know, businesses are looking for one solution that can essentially do it all for both internal and external communication. So they're looking for solutions that combine something like call center and or contact center with the unified communication and collaboration features that will help their internal employees have a high level of communication so that they are being able to collaborate, especially now that a lot of businesses have adopted a hybrid workplace model. They, you know, are looking for technology that will be able to facilitate that, as well as enabling their employees to effectively communicate with their customers. I can't stress enough the importance of customer experience. And I know, Clint, I think that we've talked about this in previous podcasts, but customer experience is so important in today's world. It really just takes one poor customer experience for someone to take to Twitter and, you know, talk about their poor experience or to potentially look to your competitors. So it's really important to be able to, you know, offer a solution that fits both of those needs.
Definitely. And to go back to that survey that I mentioned earlier that the Cloud Communications Alliance did, integrating a UC solution with a contact center product was actually the number one service that service providers are looking to add in the next 12 months. Because just as you hit on, Alisa, not only are businesses looking for a way to manage employees in a hybrid work model, but they're also wanting to engage with their customers when their customers want to engage with them and how their customers want to engage. So really offering that omni-channel experience and making sure that, just as you mentioned, that they're not losing customers because of a customer experience issue. And industry-wide, CX, this idea of customer experience, has been such a huge trend. I mean, I've read a handful of articles recently about trying to leverage CX as a means to continue to grow your audience, because just like you said, Alisa, people will take to Twitter, and that's really a lot of people, how they make buying decisions is based on people that they know and trust experiences.
That's right, Clint. And the survey that you referenced earlier that was conducted by the Cloud Communications Alliance really brings all of that to a head, because they found that customer engagement really is the key focus. And they did a survey of the top five services that service providers are looking to add in the next 12 months, and all five of them are related to customer engagement and customer experience. So the first one, as you mentioned, is integrating UC and contact center products. The second is an omni-channel contact center. Third, as we mentioned earlier, is CPaaS and APIs. The fourth is self-provisioning and ordering portals, which is an interesting one. It gives customers a little more flexibility when it comes to provisioning devices, getting their service up and running, and even from the ordering side of things, they don't even necessarily have to get in contact with someone at the company, and they can do it on their own terms and at their convenience, which can be really helpful for a lot of people. And then the fifth one is security products, which I'm sure goes without saying, security is huge, especially in our industry, and will continue to be growing in importance as well. And that actually brings us to the third key takeaway, which, as I'm sure everyone has been wondering where this fits into the conversation, but Microsoft Teams. And I'm sure we're all thinking that it wouldn't be a conversation about communications and the future without talking about Microsoft Teams. There was an entire panel dedicated to discussing Microsoft Teams. And the question of is Microsoft Teams a friend or a foe was raised. And I feel like the answer that most of the panelists gave was a very interesting one. What did you think about that, Clint?
Yeah, the best way that I felt it was articulated was actually Patrick Watson, who is a senior analyst with Cavell, was asked very directly, should we be worried about Teams or should we be happy about Teams? And he said, you know, both. We should be worried and supportive of Microsoft Teams coming into the cloud comm space. So for how the industry should think about Teams, he kind of outlined it's a foe in the sense that Teams just has the name recognition and it will really become a default path for a lot of businesses just because of their familiarity with Office 365, which Teams is now a part of that bundle. For Patrick, he sees this as basically Teams is going to continue taking some very basic telephony business from the cloud comms market. So think about this as SMBs who use Office 365 for Word, Excel, PowerPoint may get a handful of voice plans for their users to make outbound sales calls or to receive inbound customer service queries. But really, that's about the limitation of where Microsoft Teams is right now. Throughout the conference, people were very quick to point out that Teams has plenty of gaps. The biggest one, especially tied to our last big point, the importance of CX right now, there's no contact center solution with Microsoft Teams. So that's just a huge gap that people need based on the survey that we've referenced a few times. Like, that's kind of a non-starter for a lot of people. So that's really where Teams can be an opportunity for service providers who are meant to be the voice specialists within Teams. So there's a need to provide the integrations that Microsoft Teams doesn't have, any features beyond the sort of basic voice functionality that Teams doesn't have. So really, it's a friend in the sense of Microsoft just simply doesn't have telecom expertise, and this is where service providers can hitch their wagon to Microsoft Teams and really be a value add for their customers.
Exactly. And I think the ultimate takeaway from the discussion around Microsoft Teams is that it's important for service providers to offer at least some form of integration with Microsoft Teams.
Definitely. Couldn't agree more. At this point, there's no way that anybody can pretend like Microsoft Teams isn't a huge player in the market and isn't somebody that their customers are going to be very familiar with.
Exactly. But like you said, there's still a huge opportunity here for service providers to continue being the telecom expert for their customers while providing that integration with Microsoft Teams. So essentially offering their customers the best of both worlds and essentially becoming one step closer to being a one-stop shop for their customers, which in today's day and age is really important.
Definitely. Couldn't agree more. On the topic of Microsoft Teams, a little bit different from the friend or foe conversation, but there was a influencers and analysts panel that I found to be probably my favorite part of the whole conference. It's always great to get those big industry insiders sitting down together and kind of talking through a lot of the pressing topic in the industry. And obviously, Microsoft Teams came up. And Dave Michaels, who is a very big name in the industry analyst, made this great point about Microsoft Teams that it's really a software-based client. So he was really contemplating what the role of a software-based client is moving forward. For Dave Michaels, he mentioned that it seems like these sort of software-based clients like a Microsoft Teams are quickly becoming a legacy because they sort of necessitate a fair bit of ongoing maintenance. You have to make sure that there's upgrades and there's patches and that everybody's making those upgrades when they come due, and that functionality works sort of across versions and is backwards compatible in case somebody doesn't do the upgrade right on time or in case there's an issue with the upgrade. that software-based versus what he was really emphasizing is these newer browser-based clients where there's no real upgrades to manage, there's no software to manage, and you're really giving your customer and your customer's employees unified user experience, regardless of whether they're on a PC or a Mac. That was just sort of an interesting trend that he pointed out that I thought was worth raising here, especially in light of Microsoft Teams being, you know, one of the bigger names in the industry right now. Well, that about covers our key takeaways from this year's CloudCom Summit. Thank you so much for joining us today, and don't forget to subscribe wherever you're listening so you don't miss our next episode. And while you're there, please rate and review us. It takes just a minute of your time, and it really helps us out a lot. We'll see you next time.
Bye, everyone.